breakfast time in the madhouse. So it's about 5:30 here at the moment. Just gonna feed the gremlins. Once that's done,
hook up to this big girl and launch out there.
It's blowing probably 4 knots at the moment. It's meant to pick up to about 8 to 10 knots throughout the day. So gonna punch out, have a bit of a fish. Only got a couple marks, so we'll have a bit of a look around, see what we can find. There's probably not too much to find in a few hours, but we'll have a look. Get out, and we'll be back by lunchtime.
Pull her back out again and sit on the beach and
do what we did yesterday. Time for the beach launch bar, so it's as easy as undoing one little bolt there, swing this around. All done, back up. This gives us an extra couple of meters on the drawbar to send it back. Righto, we're on. Boat's in the water, in there.
Dude's up on the beach.
Let's go catch some fish.
Big storm rolling in out the back here, pissing down rain. Drive it over a bit.
Okay.
Drive over.
Well, we're on. West coast of Fraser. Just launched back there at the beach. Sending it. Pretty tough today, not too much on the sounder yet. A few big storms rolling in out the back. Loving it. Not having too much luck this morning. We fished Archer's gravel patch straight out the front of our camp, about 7 km offshore. Yeah, no good there. A little bit of a ledge, there's really not too much bottom there. I'll drop the GPS marks for anyone that wants to check these places out in the comments. I might put a little tab under this if you're keen, or if anyone gets across this side. We're just going to punch north now, go up to Wathumba. There's a Wathumba 1 mile reef straight out the front of the mouth. We'll have a look at that, and there's a couple more marks. The weather's pushing northerlies in now, so we're sort of going to be protected by the Wathumba and the top end of Fraser. So further up this way we go, the better it'll be, but not real flash here at the moment. Girl's having a sleep.
All wrapped up.
Keep punching up here, I think it's about 20 km, something like that. First catch. Those are pretty little colours in him.
He looks like a striped snapper or something.
Don't know. Let us know in the comments what that is. Hello, we're just leaving the Wathumba 1 mile. So right at the mouth of the Wathumba Creek. Footage we got back there, our GoPro just died. Don't know what happened to it, whether it's having electrical issues at the moment. So, gonna punch forward a little bit more up to the north. We've got a couple more marks. I'll drop the Wathumba 1 mile mark in the links below. It's a very healthy little reef system, plenty of little reefies, but there's not many big fish on that. It obviously gets hit pretty hard from all the tinnies on the west coast. But keep punching up here to the north.
Yeah, darling, it's the wave.
While we were cruising, I'm heading up this way. Just come across a little bit of a shell on the bottom, a few fish hanging up off it. Gonna pull up, have a quick fish. Something to eat.
Beers!
Time to get on the beers. Woo!
Just having a quick fish here. Ooh, I'm gonna fill it. These two popped up over here, little lovebirds. I don't know if you can see them just at the tip of my finger there. A couple big green turtles. Having a bit of fun. See him, darling?
Unfortunately, one of our GoPros packed it in and we lost all of our fishing footage for the day. Though we only managed to land a few small reefies, dropping the biggest fish of the day just before we got into the boat. Unfortunately, that's just fishing in new areas. We'll be back to continue exploring when the weather turns it on.
He's still got him. Oh no! We're just south of the Sandy Cape at the moment, so we come right up the top. Pretty shitty conditions. Found some good shows out wide. On a bit of isolated rubble that we found, just punching to the next reef, and there was good shows on it, but just couldn't convert. Got a couple little reefies. The weather's set to push in for the afternoon now, so gonna start heading back south again. The clouds are over, so it's not really showing how nice it is, but we're at Wathumba. We might try and get the drone up in the air, give you some ground here, and then
keep sending them south back to Cairns. Try and have fish on the beach of Sarvi. How good's this? We're just at the entrance to the Wathumba Creek. You can see it in here. It's low tide at the moment, so the creek runs up and around in there. There's a lot of cars and stuff parked over there. Look at the water. We're in about 4 meters here, and we can see the bottom like nothing. There's a big deep channel out in the front. See the color change just there. This is unreal. We're just sending it back down the west coast now. We're heading back to camp. Thought this is a nice spot. Pull up, have a bit of a look. Colours in the sand.
And what do you see out there?
What do you see?
A turtle and dolphin.
Turtle and dolphin.
And a jellyfish.
And a jellyfish. So the weather's coming in the Sarvi. We're going to punch back to camp. We're going to try and get this boat out of the water. As you would have seen, it's pretty shallow where we've been launching, so have a bit of fun getting it back on the trailer. Might just wait for high tide. There's a little bit more of a ramp bit further up, so we'll head back, see how we go. Might just anchor the boat up out the front for a while and wait for the tide to come in. Have a few beers on the beach. Well, we made it back. We didn't get any of that footage getting the boat out of the water. It's just blowing its absolute tits off at the moment, and there was water and waves and all the rest of it. So the boat's out.
I'm out.
We're all out. We've got screaming kids, blowing, probably blowing like 20 knots now from the north. Just horrible. It was not fun to get out of the water, that's for sure. We had water almost up the back door. Yeah, so big girl's gonna need a good wash when we get home. Try and hide out of the wind. Hopefully you can actually hear this, but we'll have a bit of fish on the beach and go from there for the afternoon. Have a few beers. Yo.
Lunchtime! What do you got?
Yay. Lunchtime in the madhouse. Well, we haven't got up to too much of Sarvi. The wind's been blowing. Went down, got into a few whiting. I think we caught like 20 whiting just off the beach here. Kept a couple of the bit better followers. Just gonna fillet them up, have a bit of a feed. girls are down playing on the beach. Hopefully you can hear me, it's a bit windy, but fillet these up and I might show you how we cook them up, and then yeah, we'll see what happens for the rest of the afternoon.
Oh, that's it. Nice clean fillets, skins, frames left. So we'll go bury this, clean that up, throw it in a Ziploc bag and send it in the fry pan.
Time to cook up the whiting. Quick test. Ooh. Make sure it's done. Either side, crispy, nice and golden. Happy days. What do you reckon?
Good. Ow! Stop hanging on my hand.
Better than a shop.
Eat him up.
Oh.
What do you reckon? You gonna eat it or no? No. Okay.
And the last one.
Oh. Almost dropped him. Oh well, that's about us for another day. A few lamb chops, a bit of salad. Watch the sun go down while we get blown away by the freaking westerly winds, but anyways,
or northerly winds,
west side, north, yeah, it's coming from that way. See you in the morning. Well, we've had a bloody eventful morning. We got up early, we thought that we'd try and beat the rain, get everything packed up and head back over the west coast. We're just getting pounded by the wind over here. I started mucking around in the boat, caught started with the awning and things. She pulled all the pegs out before I was ready to help. The awning turned into a parachute and rip clean off the ute. So we spent the morning putting the awning back on, couple new bolts. I carry all that sort of stuff with me in the canopy, so it's back up there. The boat is all wrapped up. As you can see, it's just windy, blowing its absolute tits off over here. So what we're gonna do, send it to the east coast, back through the inland track. We're not gonna get the boat back in again while we're over here. It's just the name of the game, unfortunately. When it's as windy as it is, you can't get offshore. So we'll head over there, chase a couple tailor. It's going to be shitty, raining, crap weather all day today. So we might go to the pub, have a feed, I reckon. We'll see you over there. That's it. We just dragged a 6 meter, 3 ton boat from east to west and back. There was definitely some colorful creatures on the radio that had their say about dragging a boat through there, but that's pretty much why we do it, I guess. I built this boat specifically to do what we've just done. Take a big boat places people don't really take one. Yeah, you can launch from Harvey Bay and come across, I think it's 50 or 60 k's across, and do it that way and camp on the beach if you want, but it's not impossible. It's actually pretty easy as long as you just pick your line, keep your momentum up. It's really not that bad. It's more a little bit tight than anything. But we're back on the East Coast now. Weather is still not real flash, so we're gonna cruise up here somewhere, find a camp. The girls want pancakes, so we're gonna go cook some pancakes up, and then we'll head to the pub for lunch down to Orchid Beach. So hang around. Pancakes on the beach. You shaking it? Shake. Well, we just come from Orchid Beach pub. We forgot the GoPro, so we didn't get any footage. But feed was good, a few beers. We just went and checked out Waddy. We're just heading back through the inland track to Champagne Pools and Indian Head, and back down to camp. This track's way worse than the west side track. Anyone that says any different, yeah, it's not as overgrown and as tight. The track is shit. It's so rutted out. Big deep 35 inch tires chewing it all up. Everyone that doesn't let their tires down enough and gets bogged leaves great big woo boys in it. Yeah, this track would suck to tow a boat across, I'm not gonna lie. I wouldn't enjoy doing that. So pretty glad we left the boat back at camp for this one. But we'll tackle it next time. When the weather's good, we'll head to Waddy one day with the big girl, but yeah, not this time. So still shitty weather, still overcast and raining and blowing its tits off. So yeah, we'll head back to camp. Might be a movie afternoon in the tent, maybe. See what happens. Might go for a fish for a tailor if I can find a nice little gutter out the front of camp. Might be a bit hard to see, but this is what I meant when I said the inland track to Orchid Beach is shit house. It's shocking. It's horrible. I'm doing 5 to 8 kilometers an hour and it's that bad, so yeah. It's not real flash and it's soft as shit too, so if you're towing a boat through this, you would be bogged to the ass for sure. But there's been plenty of people passing us that are doing it much faster, so maybe it's just our suspension that's shocking and not the track, but I beg to differ. This bit's not too bad. If only there was wooden planks for the whole lot, would be sweet. Anyways, just thought I'd tell you that. Oh well, it's raining. This is us for the afternoon. I think it's movies upstairs.
The fan battery? Oh.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh, how good. Nothing better than a bit of rain while you're camping. Keep you on your toes. Well, this is us for the afternoon. Disney movies in the rain, kicking back on the beach. We'll see you when it stops raining, I suppose.
Could have brought the beers up.
Who's doing the rain run for beers?
No, I set the tent up.
This is why we carry the big brick on top of our roof, so that at times like this, we've got all this room and it sets up in
2 minutes.
2 minutes in the rain. She was in the rain, I was up here, but yeah, it's that good. What are you doing, Nolan? Coloring. What are you doing? Being naughty. What are you doing?
No. Waiting for the bees. No.
So this is storm number 2 for the afternoon. Don't know if you can see us, it's a bit dark. It's only 3 o'clock and it's black, so. That's all water. It is pissing down. All right, well, we now sprung a leak. Don't know if you can see out here. We're officially, we're flooded in. We've sprung a leak. Got water dripping down from up here. The girl's bed flooded. I think we've had at least an inch or two of rain now in half hour, maybe less. And yeah, so it was good, now it's not so good. Yeah, more towels. This is how much rain we've had. Our thongs are floating away. Oh, that's cold. Oh no. Ah, well, how good. Look at this. This much. Yeah. Bloody hell. Should have parked at the top of the hill. Rain's all gone, sun's starting to come out. We decided to move our camp up the hill, out of the swamp. Just gonna get the rest of our stuff. How good's this spot? Apart from the swamp, we can nearly launch the boat in this. Look at this. Wind's back right out. Nice waves. Might even go and throw a line in one of these gutters here shortly. Just gonna move the table and this thing. Yeah. Apart from the swamp, wouldn't even know that it rained. Another big storm going out here. Hopefully that's the end of it.
Charbrouterie.
Well, the storms are gone, the sun's come out. We're just gonna enjoy the rest of the afternoon, kicking back with a few frothies. enjoying this.
Get into it.
Cheers, babe.
Cheers.
Oh well, this is about as good as it gets. Yes, we copped shit ton of rain, everything got wet, but that's camping. Wouldn't have it any other way, really. This is living. See you guys tomorrow. Well, good morning. It is the morning after the night before, which makes today Saturday. We had another storm roll through last night at about 2 o'clock, I think. So we had to bunker down again for a bit, but this morning is absolutely perfect. Waves out the back here. I think we're gonna have some bacon and eggs. Yeah, what are you gonna do? Bacon and eggs, and then we're gonna head south on the island, find another camp, and go to Lake Mackenzie, I think. How bloody good is it to wake up on the beach? Actually a lot better than what the weatherman predicted. It was meant to be like still 1.5 meter swell and 10 to 15 knot winds first up this morning, but winds dropped right out. There is a little bit of wind there, you can see it's not dead glassy, there's a bit of ripple on it, but really, how good. Morning.
Morning.
Hello. Bacon and eggs. Let's go. What's cooking, good looking?
Bacon and eggs.
What do you got?
Weet-Bix.
What have you got? Weet-Bix. Park the boat up, sorry. and then we'll send it into Lake Mackenzie for a swim. Campsites, they're not very big boat friendly and they're really not that nice either, so a lot of trees overhanging and stuff. The dunes are a bit steep for the big boat, and we've decided that we're just gonna keep sending it south, jump on the barge and camp up at Inskip for the night. Kids gonna have play in the water over there, might try and get a bit more ice for the beers. What else are we gonna do? Lay on the beach and do nothing. I'll go to the markets tomorrow. Yeah. If the weather keeps up like this, I might just put the boat back in. Pretty nice out there. Definitely a lot better than what they were originally predicting. Yeah, you're talking too. Yeah, so tomorrow is actually meant to glass right out in the morning and then picks up again in the arvo, but we've got to get home, so we'll probably miss that window as well. Anyways, that's fishing, camping. Yeah, keep cruising south and we'll see you when we get to Inskip. Hopefully we don't get bogged. Oh well, that's the end of our first Fraser trip with the big girl. Look at it, got bust ups out the back here. Guys are up something. Just waiting in line, get back on the barge, head back over to Inskip. Might be time for a beer, I reckon. That's bloody service if ever I've seen it. Gonna drop the barge right on the front for us. Holy. Fraser, all over. With all the rain that's been around, Inskip was a breeze. Glad we're not heading over today though, that lineup is horrendous. So, go find another campsite I suppose over at Inskip, or here at Inskip, and set up again. We'll set up for the day, have some beers. Well, we didn't film too much more at Inskip. We just kicked back on the beach for a while, had a few beers. We're home now. It's time to clean up. Everything is covered in salt, in sand, in everything. So clean the cover first. It's covered in sand and salt water. Clean all that off, give the motor a flush, then we'll start pulling that cover off. Wash all the gear, wash all the salt water and sand and stuff off these, all the max tracks. Then we'll start on the car, chassis rails, all the belly plates, everything will have to get washed down. Got the mattresses out of the rooftop there and there because they're full of water. Yeah, the rooftop out, canopy's all clean already, so yeah, all the fun stuff. But it's done, we did it. We got the big girl over the west coast of Fraser. Tick that one off the bucket list. Yeah, so that's about it. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Follow the rest of our videos. And we'll see you on the next one. Cheers.